Hi everyone, I'm Pooja Purswani and today I'll be speaking about VR, Internet of Things, and their combination. So when VR meets IoT, life beyond Second Life. So before that, let me introduce myself. I'm a tech speaker in Mozilla. I'm a social media specialist at Holger Tech Media and an electronics engineer. So now coming back to the point, what is virtual reality? So imagine you are reading a book and you start imagining yourself inside that book and you start imagining whatever written and you start picturing yourself in your head. So that is actually virtual reality, an example of virtual reality. You are basically dreaming, but with your eyes open. So, yeah. So now there are four key elements which are required to experience the virtual reality. The first one is the virtual world, which you are going to explore. So this is the picture or the scene you are going to explore to get the experience. And the next is the immersion, which means you have to presence. You have to be present at that virtual world, both mentally and physically. And then comes the interactivity, where you have to interact and show your immersion into that virtual world. And last but not the least is the sensory feedback. Since you are exploring that virtual world, you are there, you are present into that world and you're interacting, there should be some feedback. So that feedback is sensory feedback, which can be in the form of audio, video, or sometimes in the form of motion. So now let's have a glimpse of how it all started. So in 90s, the virtuality was there. They built a set of games for arcade. So these were actually the 3D games, which allows you to play the games, and they were present in the malls. But unfortunately, this is how it looked like, and as you can see, the graphics were so poor at that time. So virtuality folded by the late 90s. So coming to the today's scenario, yeah. So coming to the today's scenario, nowadays there are a large number of startups venturing in virtual reality, and a huge variety of VR headsets are available in the market. As you can see, from the very cheapest and the simplest one, which is the Google DIY box, to the very high-end one, you can use whatever you want according to your convenience and need. So, all the credit goes to the smartphone era. Your smartphones today are so advanced that you cannot even, they have so many features available today that you cannot even imagine a decade ago available in your high-end laptops or high-end computer devices. So, and everything in your phone is, smartphone is connected to the cloud. And speaking of cloud, in 2017, around 98% of the VR devices sold are for mobile devices. So yeah, smartphone era has a huge impact in VR virtual reality. So yeah, speaking of cloud, Internet of Things came into the frame, and you can actually, everything which is connected to the internet and is communicating and sharing the data, exchanging the data, comes into Internet of Things. So yeah, these things. Now, like what is Internet of Things? So yeah, things can be any devices which is connected to the internet and is sharing the data and basically communicating with each other into the form of the data. So yeah, then why IoT? Why do we need it? So one of the major promise of IoT is to make world a smarter place, which can only be happen when you have the right information at the right time. So basically, you have IoT's main motto is to give access to all the information at the right time. So yeah, it's literally everywhere. As in the previous two talks, you have already heard about the presence of IoT. It's literally everywhere. You just name a place and you find it already there. Be it your vehicle, your home, your smartwatch, refrigerators, hospitals. Yeah. So yeah. Now these two technologies, virtual reality and IoT, are separately a huge are booming. So what wonders can happen when we combine these two? So the foremost thing is the telepresence. So telepresence is actually like you make phone calls and you can send your voice at a distance. So with the help of telepresence, you can actually be at distance while not being there. So yeah, in which VR will give you the vision and IoT will give you the sense of hearing, touch and control. So and by combining these two together, you can actually open a door to a new, whole new world. So, so with the availability of low-cost, small-size sensors, you can enable the things in virtual reality communicate to the things which are actually real. So, it's an ultrasonic sensor. If I use this, as you can see, it's very small and it is as cheap as $1. And by using this small sensor, I can, if I'll put this sensor in this door, so I can get the information about the state of the door, like whether the door is open or it's closed, like how many times the door has been open or closed. So yeah, these all things you can actually do with this combination. So yeah, this is I, along with my team, we built a prototype of telepresence bot for farming purpose. So yeah, this is the picture taken by that bot. So yeah, and the prototype of the bot consists of an Arduino, which is connected to a Raspberry Pi. So basically, the Raspberry Pi's the Wi-Fi, inbuilt Wi-Fi in the Raspberry Pi is giving commands to that Arduino, and the Arduino is controlling the motors. For the which and the motors are responsible for the motions, and a camera is mounted over the motors, having a pan and tilt motion. So the pan, I'll show you the demo at the last, how the pan and tilt motion works there. And there are four sensors which are used as air humidity sensors, light and soil moisture sensor, and temperature sensor. And these sensors are actually, the name is self defining the functions of them. And at the user end, there is a VR device headset along with a mobile device where the user can actually move his head and can see the field and see the actual scene of that, where the bot is being placed. So yeah, here I can explain you with some. See, the farming bot has a camera which is streaming the video of the field. What's the main scenario in this case? It's the field, agricultural field. And the motions are, the bot is moving left, right, up, forward and backward. And the other one is for the camera, pan and tilt. So pan and tilt will work since the mobile devices you are using inside your VR devices. So when you move your head, so it will move like that. And you can see the, and you can feel the virtual reality, your telepresence there. And the sensors here are for the, of measuring the various parameters required for the agriculture. So so the major advantage of this bot is that it is designed using the web server, and which is accessible via internet. So a farmer can log in from anywhere in the world and can see the entire scenario of the field and can measure the various parameters and can see, okay, what is happening, what is actually happening at the field while not presenting actually at the field. So it can enable the farmer to prevent the field from various threats like droughts and floods, and can also help farmer to maintain their field and can ease of farming, and it can actually provide the ease of farming. So these are the few readings we got, results and graphs we got from the bot. So the soil reading here says that, since the bot was moving towards the high moisture area from the low moisture area, you can see the reading patterns here, and the temperature reading here shows that a drop since the bot was in the functioning mode for 8 hours. So you can see the temperature down and up since it was a span of from day to night. And the light there shows, since the bot was moving, it went under the shed. So you can see the drop in the light, and it was there. The pattern shows that it was moving under the shed and it came out of the shed. So yeah. Now, apart from this farming and what are the other applications of telepresence? So there are many places which you cannot, where the human presence is not actually possible, or it's really difficult. Even if it's possible, it's really difficult for humans to present at that time and there. So like medical training and distance education, interactive learning and workshops, and many other things can be done. Like mining maintenance is one of the most difficult thing where you human presence is like they are risking their lives. So you can use telepresence for mining maintenance and military and defense, and many other applications can be present there. And since we and my team and I are working on the prototype, and for and we are adding more features to it. So yeah. And also it's a best solution for the long distance relationship. So yeah. Okay, let me show you the demo for how it works, the pan and tilt. As you can, okay, it's not visible here. So as you can see, as you're moving your head up and down and right and left, the bot's head is also moving. See, so this is how it works. And also, see, this is an example of how you can solve your other problems as well. So you can actually be there by not even being there. So yeah, this is it. Any questions? Yeah.
So what's the response time when, you know, have you tested how responsive is it from your actions?
It won't take much time. It's like it's really responsive when you move the head. So yeah, it'll show the exact response. So there is no more delay in that. At least a negligible one, you can say that.
That's within your lab environment. Or what if you go out to a cloud overseas, you know,
sorry?
Long distance.
Sorry.
is that only in a lab environment that's very immediate? Does physical distance, like if you're in another country, controlling a machine in another country, will it be slower?
Yeah, for inside the lab, it was a negligible one, but for long distance, yeah, we have to test it, but because we haven't tested it yet. But yeah, there might be a delay, but not that much. So yeah, there will be a like minor one, but not that much. So that, yeah. Any other questions? No more questions. Okay. So, if you feel like you have any other questions, you can tweet me at, so this is my Twitter handle. You can tweet me. I'll be more than happy to answer all your questions. So this is it for today. Thank you.